So now we're going to talk about one of the more intimidating aspects of creating a professional video for your business or organization, and that's the editing process.
But have no fear, we are here.
Yeah, there's really nothing to be scared of because editing platforms, whether you're using a professional platform like Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro for Macs, they're all very, very similar. And what I'm going to show you here in this video on how the basics of editing, essentially, is that when you learn those basics, you can really apply them regardless of what platform you're using, whether it's one that you pay for or whether it's one that you download for free off the internet. And welcome everyone. Here we're going to talk about the basics of video editing. So today we're going to talk about all the different ways that you can edit the raw footage that you've shot on your camera, your phone, or maybe it's a DSLR camera that you have. Now, when you use video editing software, there are several, and I mean several different options. Now, you can download video editing software free from the internet, and there are literally dozens of options. That's what I am using here today. This particular one is called OpenShot Video Editor. I believe that this one is intuitive enough that it will kind of give you the basics, and if you can understand this, you can understand the basics of most video editing software. So that's what I want you to walk away with today. I want you to walk away with the basics of making an edit, making a transition, adding to two different tracks for your timeline in your final video, and you'll see what I mean here in a second. But there are all kinds of different video editing software, from ones that you pay for, like Adobe Premiere Pro, Final Cut Pro, to ones that you download for free off of the internet, like this one, OpenShot Video Editor, or perhaps DaVinci Resolve. There are several options. Most all of them work the same way. You import video, you edit the video in a timeline, you add music, maybe some pictures, some graphics, and then you export the video out of the program and onto your desktop or laptop or whatever as an MP4 or a .mov file, and then you share it to social media or your website. Now, here's how I'm going to show you. Most video editing software goes like this. You can see you go into import files, and in this particular instance, we're going to talk about a winter day. This past winter, my daughter was outside and built a snowman and saw our chickens outside and then came inside and lost a tooth. So what I would suggest when you shoot video, you create a dedicated folder for all of your raw video footage, right? And name the folder. In this particular instance, it's August, and I'm going to pick the three video files that I want to use in this project here, and then we will open, and you'll see them all be imported into the project here. So typically they will appear in a window. It's sometimes called a bin. It's sometimes called a project folder. This one is project files. And you can see that the files are named basically what the camera named them. My DSLR camera named those files A776338.mov. I'm going to change the names because sometimes you work with multiple files, and I'm saying like 50, 60, 70 files at a time, and you want to keep them organized. So when you do that, you want to rename them as you import them. So this one, August loses tooth, and the next one will be August builds snowman here. Hold on. Builds snowman. And then the last one will be chickens. Now, you certainly don't have to do this. I just do this for organizational purposes because files can get out of control, especially when you have dozens of them. In this case, I probably don't need to name them because I only have three, but I think it's good practice. So what you'll do, and once you import the footage that you have from your camera or from your DSLR or whatever camcorder that you're using, you're going to then move the video down into your timeline. So let's start with August Builds a Snowman. Let's move that down into track five. Now notice, this particular software has five different tracks available, but you can also add more tracks. So I can go and click add 6, 7, right? So I can add tons of tracks. So we'll just move this up to the top.
And basically what that means is you can have video on top of other video, on top of other video, on top of music, on top of pictures. It's all, it's non-linear editing, right? So I'm using track 7 here for my video, but as you'll see later, I'm going to use track 6 for my audio, a song that I've downloaded to play with this video that I'm going to create. So now you want to start to make edits. So most all video editing software, you hit the spacebar button, it starts and it stops your file that you're looking at. So let's hit space. And you can see. August is rolling a snowman. Let's stop it there. Notice how she rolls the snowman, the beginning of the snowman, out of the frame. And typically, most video editing software, there's usually a razor tool or scissors that you can click on, which I'm clicking on here. And you can click on your file in the timeline and make an edit. Now that we've made this edit, we're actually just going to click on the part of the video that we don't need here. And I accidentally added another track there. We'll click on the second half of this video that we don't need here, and we can just delete it. So we've made that edit here for the first shot of August rolling that snowball, or the bottom part of the snowman. So that's the first shot we need. Okay, let's go to the next shot that we need outside, and that is the chickens. Let's click on this and drag it down. So there's the chicken video. We'll place it right next to August rolling the snowman. And when we hit the space bar on the timeline, we'll play it. And let's see here. It'll come to the end of August rolling the snow and then straight to a shot of my two chickens there. That's Peanut and Strawberry. So let's get a shot of Peanut and Strawberry for about 10 seconds or so. Maybe there and as well, the brown chicken. Pause it. And let's go where it kind of pans over to Ann there. So there's Peanut and Strawberry, and then it pans over to Ann, and then let's stop it like right there. So you can see on the timeline where I've scrubbed that over to the portion of the video where I want to clip it. Click on the razor blade tool, clip it right there, and then we'll delete the rest. Just click it and hit delete on your keyboard, the video that you don't need. So right now we have going from August rolling the snowman to the chickens, and then it kind of pans over from our Peanut and Strawberry there over to Anne standing right to the left of them, right there. Perfect. So we're talking about a winter day. Okay, then after that, I want a shot of going after we're done outside, we're going to go inside to August at the table telling us about how she lost her tooth. So we're going to go to the beginning of the clip, play it.
Go ahead.
Dad, hi, what? I lost my tooth.
Tell us how it happened.
Well, I was just crunching some of my bananas, and all of a sudden, my tooth just fell right out. It was
So I'm going to end it after she says, "That's so crazy." Let's go back and make sure we get it right where we need it.
Ow! It was so crazy!
Right there. Okay. So we'll clip it, just like we had before, and delete the part that we don't need. So now we have edited 3 different video files, and we've trimmed them down into the portions that we need for the video, and we've placed them all next to each other in the timeline. Right now, looking on the timeline, you can see the clip itself, the video that we've created, is just under 45 seconds long. You can kind of see that if we look right here. Let's go here, right here. And if we make this a little larger, we can see it is about 40 seconds or so long, right there. Okay, so what I want to do now is I want to add a couple of transitions. Now, in between the clips where you've made your edits, you can see on the timeline, if usually in most editing software, if you right-click, there is an option to fade. You can fade at the start of the clip, the end of the clip. So we're going to go fade start of the clip, fade in fast. And then we're going to go to this clip and right-click, and then fade end of clip out fast. So what that does is this, and you'll see when we play this. Ready? Kind of goes to black and then comes up into the new clip. It just gives it a little bit of effect. So for this clip, at the end of the second one with the chickens, we'll go fade. Let's see here. Animate. What else do we have? I'm just looking at the different options. Well, I like the fade at the end of the clip fast and then fade into the beginning of this clip fast. I kind of like how that looks, how it kind of dips to black and then comes up from black at the end. So start a clip here, fade in fast. Okay, and the end of our clip, we're going to fade out slow. So fade, end of clip, out slow. Okay, perfect. Now, what we need is to add some music. Now remember, in the beginning of this, I talked about how I kept all my files in the same folder. Now, in the same folder that I drug all these files in from, I have a music file that I want to use. So we're going to go back up to file, remember, and you're going to import files. And in that folder, I have a song right here that I'm going to click. And I'm going to drag that song down into track 6 below my video, okay? So now that that music's down there, listen to this. So you can hear the video, okay? So that's good. So we have the video down there, and we're going to basically let that video play until my daughter, August, starts talking in that last clip. So what I want to do is I want to make an edit before that last clip to cut the video or cut the audio off so it doesn't overpower my daughter talking. So that's something to remember too. When you're adding music to whatever video that it is that you're using, you don't want the music to overpower the person talking. So we're going to go to the Razor tool and we're going to go right here where in track 6 where that audio file is, and we're going to cut it right before that track starts where my daughter is talking. So did that there. We're going to delete the rest of the music and let's see how that sounds. There we go. Perfect. So I wanted the music to end before my daughter started talking. All right, so it doesn't overpower her. So now we're done. We're done with the video. We're done with this pretty simple video that we did. We made some pretty basic edits, but again, there's all kinds of other bells and whistles depending on what kind of software you're using. Now all we need to do is export this thing out. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up to File. We're going to go to where it says Export Project and export the video. And we are going to name it. So this is August Winter Day. And we're going to put it in the folder that I've already created for this. And we're going to export it as an MP4. Now, you can also usually have several options. You can export it as an MOV file. You can export it as an MP4 file. All kinds of different things. But usually, MP4 H.264 or MOV H.264 is a high-quality video. So you want to do it that way. So I'm going to go MP4 H.264 right here. And then export video. And we're going to have a little timeline there in the bottom, a percentage, depending on how far it's done. And we'll just wait for that to export. And then once we're done, we'll go to the folder and check the video and make sure it worked. And that's it. And that's how you create a video that you can use for your business, for your own personal use, for really whatever. But if you get used to using editing software, again, many of them are very similar. I think you'll find that there are all kinds of different options. Now, I added some simple music and some video that I shot, but you can also add pictures. You can add images that you've maybe created through Photoshop or whatever you use to edit imagery. And you can add all kinds of things, especially as you can see, there's so many different tracks that you can just add all different kinds of media on. Okay, so once this is done exporting, which it's about done, we will check that and hit done. And let's go to the folder really quick here. We'll go to August right here. And there it is, August's Winter Day. Let's see how it looks. Nice. All right, so very good, everyone. Hopefully you found that informational. Hopefully you learned something. But again, just, I can't stress enough, just edit things like this and you'll learn so quick. And you'll learn also that the different video platforms that you can use to edit video are really similar, depending on whether or not you, even if you don't pay for them, even if you download a free one, or maybe you have something like Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro, the basics are the same. Timelines, nonlinear editing, adding music, adding transitions, cutting, using a razor blade, you know, to edit your video. It's all very similar. So hopefully you found that informative, and we just hope that you continue to create and just be creators of media.